Hi everybody, again, I'm not quite prepared. Thanks for that action, Chasey. So, again, unfortunately, the never-ending stream of Christian persecution continues. And I'm now going to read quite a troubling story, actually. And it's about an individual. And I find that even though we're all compassionate in our own ways, stories of individuals tend to touch the heart more so than multiple deaths and stuff. So basically, in Egypt, it's very simple. An elderly Christian woman was stripped naked and beaten and has been denied justice, it says again. So this is from an article by Raymond Ibrahim. It says, once again, the Egyptian court system seems committed to denying justice to Egypt's Coptic Christian community. They are a minority. For the second time in a row, a court involved in the case of the unconscionable abuse of an elderly Christian woman has just recused itself. The case has been postponed several times and was closed in 2017 due to insufficient evidence. However, the woman's legal reps have filed a grievance and reopened it again. Then in March 2019, the Minya Felony Court decided to withdraw from hearing the case due to embarrassment. So basically, the lady is called Soad Thabet, and she is a Christian grandmother in her 70s. So if you could all just stop and picture your own grandmother. On May the 20th, 2016, a mob of some 300, not 299, not five, 300 Muslim men descended on her home, stripped her completely naked, beat her, spat on her, and paraded her in the streets of Al Kham village in Minya Governorate. She was jeered, whistled, and there were obviously shouts of, you know, slogans. I'm not going to read it out. And her crime, this is her crime, everybody. Her son was falsely accused of having a romantic relationship with a Muslim woman, which is banned by Islamic law or Sharia, the same body of teachings that prescribes the collective punishment of non-Muslim infidels. So basically, she's been awaiting justice since then. She's been many times to court, and unfortunately, Egypt's discrimination of Coptic Christians, who are obviously in the body of Christ, like, it's just unconscionable, to be fair. It's abuse, it's elder abuse. It's the stripping naked and spitting on whilst parading through the street of a lady in her 70s. So I'd like you all, please, to specifically pray for this lady. I'll post the link in the description box. Please pray in general for Coptic Christians. Maybe find out a bit more about what they believe. They're Arabic-speaking Christians. They are of Egypt, and therefore Egypt no longer has its own language. It's completely Arabized. Please do look into it. Pray for Egyptian Christians of all denominations. Pray for us here at the park as we pray for you. Come and see us on Discord and we can discuss this persecution, because nobody else seems to be. I don't mean I'm a lone voice, but I mean that the mainstream, unfortunately, doesn't mention Christophobia at all, treats it as if it's a made-up word. And I'm just pretty sick of it, and I hope you are too by now, because I actually prayed for this focus and now I've got it. And I'd like you to join me too. So I'm not asking you to give money to them. I'm asking for your prayers. Please sincerely and earnestly pray that the Holy Spirit would pour himself out onto these abusers of elderly ladies, onto these murderers of Nigerian Christians, onto the rapists and forced converters of Christian Pakistani girls, as well as their Hindu counterparts. Please do join me in spreading this video. Like it, comment, subscribe, come along and chat to us on Discord. The link will be in the description box. God bless you and keep you until I see you next time. Bye-bye.